What's up, Lubinati? It's that time of year again when free agency is upon us. I know many of you have questions about it, so hopefully I can answer some of those in this video series. What is free agency? How does it work? What are the key dates? And most importantly, how is it going to affect you or your team? Before we get to the current free agency landscape, it helps to understand how things used to be. So let's take a trip back in time. Back in the day, before free agency existed, teams had complete control over a player's career. They would sign a player, develop them through the minors, and then pay them whatever salary the team wanted. Players had no ability to sign somewhere else upon completing their contract with the team because their original team always reserved the right to renew the player's contract once it was finished. This was known as the reserve clause. It gave the club the right to renew a player's contract even if the player didn't want it to be renewed. Players equated this situation to slave labor because they essentially had no say over where they worked. And Curt Flood was the first to challenge this concept. Flood's case made it all the way to the Supreme Court, and although he ended up losing, he was the first player to really bring attention to this inequity. 3 years later, in 1975, the reserve clause was challenged again, this time by Andy Messersmith and Dave McNally. However, instead of challenging the clause in a court of law, they challenged it in front of a labor arbitrator, who ultimately ruled in their favor, granting players the right to become free agents and ending the team's right to perpetually renew player contracts. Following that ruling in 1975, a new CBA was negotiated between MLB and the Players Association, in which owners and players agreed that players would have the right to become free agents after acquiring at least 6 years of major league service. And it's really been that way ever since. So nowadays, when a player reaches 6 years of major league service, or when they are released by an organization prior to reaching 6 years of major league service, they are free to negotiate and sign with any team for any terms that both parties agree to. Free agency has become a huge part of the baseball industry, and I'm sure a lot of your favorite teams have signed free agents that have helped them win a lot of games. So you have Andy, Dave, and Curt to thank for that. Hopefully you now understand what free agency is and how it all got started. In the next video, I'll go over the free agency calendar, give you some important dates to watch out for, and explain a little bit about what's going to happen on each of those dates. So I'll catch y'all in the next video.